Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Lab covering component selection for SAR ADCs. In this video, we will learn how to use the Texas Instruments parametric search tools to find an amplifier that will meet your application requirements. We will also learn how to verify that the SPICE model is accurate and sufficient for SAR drive simulations. This video covers steps 4 and 5 of the process for selecting the external components for a SAR ADC. Let's start by choosing the right op-amp. There are over 1,000 different amplifiers to choose from, so how do we find the right one? TI's parametric search engine is a good way to narrow down the choices. To get to this tool, click on the Amplifiers Products on TI.com. In the Amplifiers section, click on Operational Amplifiers, Op-Amps, and from here, select the Products tab and use the Quick Search feature. In this case, we want a single-channel amplifier with a 5-volt supply. Based on the results from the calculator, we need at least 17.8 MHz of bandwidth. After entering in this information, the number of choices is narrowed down to 22 devices. At this point, we can continue to select filters to narrow down our options. First, we can put an upper limit of 50 MHz on the bandwidth. We do this because bandwidth beyond 50 MHz is probably overkill for this design. Next, let's choose a package style. In this case, we use SOT23. DC performance is also important, so we limit the offset to be less than 0.5 millivolts. Finally, we limit the rating to be catalog devices only. At this point, the number of choices is limited to 3 devices. We select the OPA320 for our design as it has the best offset. Note that in some cases, you may find that no devices meet your criteria. In this case, you will have to step back through the filtering process and make some compromises in your design requirements. Once you have selected your amplifier, you need to get a TINA SPICE model, as the ADC drive optimization and verification is done in SPICE. The best way to find the model is to go to the Tools and Software tab on the TI.com landing page for that product. In some cases, this model is included with the TINA SPICE software package, but it is better to get the model from TI.com, as this assures that you get the most up-to-date model. Also, it is recommended that you download and open the reference design, as it is a pre-wired test circuit that you can use as the basis for your design. Let's now move on and verify the op-amp simulation model. It is very important to verify the accuracy of the model you use for SAR drive simulations. For this kind of application, bandwidth, open loop gain, and open loop output impedance are important to achieve accurate results. Most modern models are sophisticated and cover these and many other parameters. However, it's easy to check the models, and it's better to be confident in its operation. This slide shows how you would test the model for open loop gain. First, for this test, the amplifier needs to be in the linear operating range. So in this case, the input signal is set to 2.5 volts to make sure that the output is at mid-scale and not driving into a rail. The feedback network contains a large 1 terahenry inductor to open the loop for AC signals and short the loop for DC signals. This allows for a good DC operating point but keeps the loop open so that we can do open loop analysis. The 1 terafarad capacitor disconnects the AC signal from the DC operating point and connects the source for any AC frequencies of interest. In the center, we show the TINA SPICE simulation results, and at the right, we show the datasheet specification for open loop gain. To compare the two plots, look at a few points on the magnitude and phase plot. Some key points to consider are the DC gain and the unity gain bandwidth on the magnitude plot. In the phase plot, check the phase at the unity gain bandwidth frequency. Note that sometimes the phase plot will be off by 180 degrees as the phase depends on how the circuit is measured. In this example, you see good agreement between the simulated results and the datasheet curve. Another important curve is the open loop output impedance. This curve is ideally flat and low for fastest ADC settling. The circuit used for this test is similar to the open loop gain test, as the feedback loop is broken for AC but is shorted for DC operation. The output here is connected to an AC current generator, and a voltage measurement probe is included. Also notice that the input is biased so that the output will be in a linear voltage range. Again, for any simulation, it is important to verify the DC operation before the AC simulation. This helps avoid problems caused by incorrect wiring. Once the circuit is connected and its DC operation is confirmed, you can run the AC analysis AC transfer characteristic. For this simulation, the output voltage is equal to the open loop output impedance, that is, ZO in dB equals Vout in dB. Make sure that you change the vertical axis to logarithmic and scale to match the datasheet curve. In this case, you can see that the simulation result closely matches the datasheet specification, so this model has properly modeled open loop output impedance. Some amplifier datasheets will provide an open loop output impedance, or ZO, specification, and others will provide a closed loop, or Zout, curve. The two curves are directly related, so it is sufficient to verify either curve. So in cases where the datasheet provides a closed loop output impedance curve, you can simulate this test circuit. One key tip to decide if the impedance curve is open loop output impedance ZO or closed loop output impedance Zout is to see if the curve specifies a gain for the test condition. In our example, we see three curves, and each specifies a Gin, G equals 1, G equals 10, and G equals 100, indicating that these are closed loop output impedance curves, or Zout. Since this is closed loop impedance, the feedback network is set according to the required gain. This example shows a gain of 1, but other gains may be needed depending on the datasheet graph. The output is connected to a current generator and a voltage measurement probe. Closed loop output impedance is equal to the output voltage in this simulation. That is, Zout in dB equals Vout in dB. By changing the y-axis to logarithmic, we get Zout in ohms. In other words, Zout in ohms equals Vout in logarithmic. Notice that the simulation results closely match the datasheet curve for unity gain. The next video will walk through step 6 of the process and build the SAR-ADC model. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of this video's content.